Welcome to the all-new BuckSort app, an industry-leading hunting application designed to sort, organize, and tag trail camera photos while also providing advanced hunting insights. In this tutorial, we will cover all the necessary steps to get you started. When first launching the app, you will be taken to the cameras page under the Photos tab. If this is your first time opening the app, you will see a blank screen prompting you to add a camera. To add a camera, tap the Add Camera button on the top of the screen. A form will appear asking you to set up your camera. Complete the form by entering the appropriate information. Near the end of the form, you will notice two questions asking about the camera's location and heading. To enter the location of the camera, you have three options. The easiest option is to tap the Find Location button. This will find the location of your mobile device or tablet and enter it as the location of the camera. However, this method will only work if you have connectivity, and it will only be accurate if you are actually standing where you are placing your camera. An alternative method is to survey in the camera using the satellite map. To do this, simply tap the Select on Map button to be taken to the map. Once inside the map, press and hold on the location on the map where you'd like to place your camera, then tap Save Location. If this method also does not work, tap the field next to the location question and simply enter the coordinates of your camera in decimal degrees. In addition to location, the form will also ask for the camera heading. To lock in the camera heading, you have two options. The easiest option is to tap on the Get Compass Heading button. Tapping the button will launch a compass and allow you to point your device in the same direction your camera is pointing. Then tap Save. Depending on your device, the live compass readout may require connectivity. If this is the case, and you do not have connectivity near your camera, either set the heading when you do have connectivity, or simply tap in the heading field and manually type in the heading of the camera between 0 degrees and 360 degrees. After completing the form, click Create Camera, and you'll see the camera within the cameras page. The camera will be identified by its name, the property it has been assigned to, and its physical location. If desired, the geo-coordinate below the property name is hyperlinked and can be tapped on to locate the camera within the Maps app. To return to the BuckSort app, simply click the back button on the top left of the Maps app. Once you have added a camera, you can now add photos to the camera. To get the most accurate hunting insights, be sure to only add photos to the camera that are specifically associated with that camera. To import photos, tap on the Import Photos button on the top of the screen. When importing photos, you have two data sources you can pull from, either the photo library or an SD card. If you are utilizing an SD card reader with your device, you can import directly into BuckSort. Alternatively, you can also import your photos into your photo library and later import your photos into BuckSort via the photo library. When importing photos, select the photos you would like to import and then click Done. The photos will immediately begin importing into the app. A convenient progress bar will display import status. Once the photos have been imported, they can now be viewed within the BuckSort app. Users can scroll through their photos, tap on specific images to view in full screen, or sort the photos. To sort the photos within BuckSort, users have two options. By tapping on the Sort button on the top of the screen, users can either sort by creation date, which sorts the photos from newest to oldest based on the taken date, or classify, which uses AI to automatically sort photos into subfolders based on the animals captured within the photos. When using the Classify button, users are leveraging BuckSort's artificial intelligence capabilities. A convenient progress bar will show the status of the automated sorting process. The speed at which the sorting will run is dependent on your device. In general, older devices will run slower and newer devices will run faster. If you are sorting many photos, it is good practice to ensure your device doesn't go to sleep. If it does, it's not a huge deal, but the app will only sort those photos it has completed identifying prior to the device going to sleep. If you are sorting many photos at one time, you may want to modify the sleep parameter on your device. To do this on iOS, go to the Settings app and then scroll down and tap on Display and Brightness. Next, scroll down and tap on Auto Lock, and you'll have several options for screen timeout. Selecting a time from the list will keep your device awake for that amount of time before it automatically goes to sleep. Selecting Never will keep your device awake until you put it to sleep manually by clicking the power button. If your device sorts your photos fast enough, in other words, prior to the screen timing out, you do not need to change the display settings on your device. However, if you are running a slower device and your screen will time out before the sorting process has completed, it is a good practice to either change your display settings or simply sort the remaining number of photos when you wake your device back up. When sorting is completed, you will see a series of subfolders with photos. Depending on what has been identified in your photos, you will likely see a folder for white-tailed bucks, does, and other animals, as well as a folder for empty photos. Presently, these are the categories your photos will be sorted into, although additional categories may be added in the future. To enter a subfolder and view the images, simply tap on the folder. When inside the folder, feel free to scroll through the photos and click on any of them to view in full screen. When viewing photos in full screen mode, you will notice some additional buttons. Starting on the top left, a back button is available to allow you to back out of full screen mode and view all the images in the subfolder. Moving to the top right, you will notice two buttons, an information button and a share button. The information button is something you will see throughout the BuckSort app. Each information button provides detailed information about the content on your screen. In this case, the information button describes the function of the classify button, which we will cover in a second. Moving over to the share button, you can tap this button to share your photo with family and friends. On the bottom of the screen, you will see a trash can button. Tapping on this button allows you to delete the photo you are viewing. Finally, on the bottom left and right-hand corners of the screen are buck aging and naming buttons. These buttons will only be active when viewing photos within the buck subfolder. The buttons will turn orange when they are active. Within all other subfolders, the buttons will be grayed out and inactive. The information button within full screen mode when inside the buck subfolder will provide information on what these buttons are used for. But, in summary, the hunting insights heat maps and charts, which we will highlight later in this video, are all filterable by buck age and name. This means if you tag your trail camera photos with ages and names, they will appear as filtering options under the maps and analytics tabs. To age a buck, simply tap the age button and select from the list. When you do this, the age you specify will be tagged to the photo. Repeat this process for all your bucks, and you will be able to filter by age groups within your maps and analytics charts. To name a buck, simply tap the name button and type out a name. Moving forward, this name becomes part of a list, allowing you to quickly tag photos of the same buck with the same name across all the photos in your buck subfolder. Naming bucks of interest will allow you to filter bucks based on name when viewing your analytics, which may help you better pattern specific bucks' movement and behavior. When sorting photos into subfolders using AI, you will get incorrect classifications. The AI isn't perfect, and its overall accuracy will be dependent on a variety of factors. We'll save the AI discussion for another video, but bear in mind that you will have photos that are misidentified. It is for this reason we allow you to easily correct these misidentifications. The Classify button on the top of the screen can be tapped to display a drop-down list of available identifications. Selecting one of these options will recategorize the photo as the selected option and refile the photo into the appropriate subfolder. Additionally, the metadata record for that photo will also record the reclassification so that your hunting insight maps and analytics charts properly display your data according to the corrected identification. One last thing to cover within the photos section is camera editing. If you ever want to edit or delete a camera, this can be done by tapping on the camera and then clicking the Edit Camera button on the top right of the screen. Doing this will pop up the camera form, where you can change all the fields associated with the camera. Additionally, you can delete the camera, along with all of its photos altogether. One thing to keep in mind though before you start editing cameras is that most of the time you'll actually want to create a new camera as opposed to editing an old camera. The reason for this is editing an old camera can throw off your analytics. Remember that the data displayed in your analytics maps and charts is partially sourced from your camera information. So if you, as an example, change the location of your camera, you will also change your analytics. Therefore, it might be best to think of the cameras you create in BuckSort as camera locations as opposed to physical cameras. Moving on from the Photos tab, the next two tabs we'll cover in this tutorial are the Maps tab and Analytics tab. Access to both of these tabs require a subscription. There are three ways to subscribe to BuckSort. If you've already downloaded the app, launch the app and tap on the Maps or Analytics tabs. A subscription pop-up will automatically appear. If it doesn't, simply tap on the Subscriptions button on the top left of the screen. From there, select the Hunt Club tab if it isn't already selected. Next, select the subscription tier you would like to purchase. Finally, complete the on-screen prompts and proceed through checkout. If you've already downloaded the app and would like to purchase the app through the App Store, launch the app, tap on the Subscriptions button, choose the subscription tier you would like to purchase, and enter your Apple ID password when prompted. If you have already subscribed through BuckSortPro.com or a reseller's website, or you would like to subscribe via BuckSortPro.com or through a reseller's website, Simply select the subscription tier you would like to purchase on the website and complete the purchase through the on-screen prompts. From there, you will receive an email with instructions on how to activate your subscription with a subscription ID that will also be included in the email. To activate your subscription, simply download the app if you haven't already, launch the app on your device, tap the subscriptions button, then select the Hunt Club tab if it isn't already selected. Then tap Restore Purchases, where you will be prompted to enter your subscription ID. Next, simply copy and paste your subscription ID, which is included in the email sent to you when you subscribed on the website, into the on-screen prompt. Then click Restore. Once you have subscribed, you will now have access to advanced hunting insights and analytics, providing detailed information on animal movement based on imported trail camera photos, associated metadata, and other variables. Starting with the heat map, an informational button is located on the top right of the screen and provides a detailed description of both the heat map and home range map. Sitting next to the information button is a sync button, which can be tapped in order to refresh the map displays with the latest data from the imported photos. The map itself functions like a typical satellite map, allowing you to pinch zoom in and out or use the zoom buttons on the top left of the map display. Also provided on the map display are a scale, located on the bottom left, and a view options button, located on the top right. Tapping on the view options button will auto-scroll you to the map filtering and time slider options, which allow you to manipulate the heat map and home range maps. If you do not use the view options menu, you can also scroll down normally using your finger. Just be sure to be touching outside the map display on the left or right hand side. If you touch inside the map display, you will move the map as opposed to moving the page. The heat map provides an overview of average animal movement based on a series of selected filters. Filtering options include time span, camera name, species, buck age, and buck name. To use the heat map, select your desired filters below the map. The first filter is the time range dropdown, which selects the span of time you want to analyze. As an example, selecting last 2 weeks will pull trail camera data only from the last 2 weeks. Next, the camera filter allows you to select which specific cameras you would like to display. Next, the species filter allows you to select the specific animals you would like the heat map to display. If you select buck as one of these filters, you will see two additional filters pop up for buck age and buck name. If you have been labeling your buck photos with names and ages, you will see these selections as filtering options. These options will allow you to see heat maps representing specific bucks if desired. After selecting all your filters, make sure to tap the Save Changes button to reset the heat map to your current filters. If you choose not to save any filters, the heat map will simply default to showing all your cameras and photo data. In addition to the filters, there is also a time slider. The time slider is a powerful tool to use after you have saved your filters. The time slider allows you to manipulate your heat map and see an hourly average of animal movement. The time slider is on a 24-hour scale. Dragging the slider will change the heat map in real time to represent the average concentration of animal movement at each camera during that hour. Additionally, beneath the filters, there are three checkboxes allowing you to alter the view of the heat map. The heat map checkbox simply turns the heat map graphics on and off. The home range zones checkbox turns the home range zones on and off. If you turn the home range zones on, a map legend will pop up in the map identifying the home range zone, core zone, and hot zone. These zones represent likely home areas of mature white-tailed bucks. If you are viewing the home range zones during the rut, check the rutting season checkbox, which will change your home range zones to be more representative of the season. Finally, if you do not have any buck photos, or you have not included bucks in your filtering options, the home range zones will not appear as they are specific to white-tailed bucks as opposed to other animals. Available research suggests white-tailed bucks have a relatively established home range. While your camera is not necessarily the center of a buck's home range, capturing the buck on your camera, or better yet, on many of your cameras frequently, suggests the areas within their home range. Observing these overlays, especially when there are overlaps between cameras, can give you a better idea of where a specific buck might live. While it is true bucks will venture outside their home range, particularly during the rut, or when pushed or pulled by some other factor, the home range overlays will give you a good idea of the expanse of a buck's regular travel. Moving on from the heat map and home range map, weather forecasting is also included under the Maps tab. To view BuckSort's weather visualization tool, simply tap on the weather switch under the Maps tab. This will launch a weather map. Once again, an informational button will be located on the top right explaining how to use the map. The weather map provides powerful weather forecast visualizations. To use the weather map, simply select the weather metric you would like visualized on the top right, and then use the time slider on the bottom of the map to see weather visualizations for a specific time. You can also tap the play button to see how conditions will change over time, on an hourly basis. At the very bottom of the map is a scale which will provide numerical readings for the selected weather metric. Available weather metrics include wind, wind gusts, wind accumulation, rain and thunder, rain accumulation, new snow, precipitation type, temperature, dew point, humidity, clouds, high clouds, medium clouds, low clouds, fog, Cape index, and barometric pressure. As with the other maps, you can pinch in and out, as well as use the zoom buttons on the top right of the weather map display. One thing to note is the weather visualization layers are limited beyond certain zoom levels. If you zoom beyond these zoom levels, the weather layer will transition to a satellite image with the locations of your cameras marked. Moving on from the Maps tab, the final tab within BuckSort is your Analytics tab. This tab will include all of your charts visualizing animal movement based on a variety of variables, including time, temperature, barometric pressure, wind speed, precipitation, and cloud cover. When first entering the Analytics tab, you will be placed on the Movement Summary page. As always, an informational button is located on the top right of the screen explaining how to read and manipulate the movement summary. The movement summary provides an overview of the time and environmental factors affecting animal movement. These factors include temperature, barometric pressure, wind speed, precipitation, and cloud cover. This summary page highlights the specific time and environmental metrics correlated with heightened animal movement, as captured by your trail camera based on the species, time span, and other filtering options selected at the bottom of the page. When reading the movement summary, the top line chart provides an overview of the number of photos of specific animals captured by your trail camera based on time. Spikes across the 24-hour scale provide insight into the specific times marked by heightened animal movement based on your selected filters. Scrolling down to the donut charts, you can view the environmental conditions most affecting animal movement based on your selected filters. Each donut chart provides the associated metric tied to heightened animal movement based on the number of photos captured of the filtered animal type. As an example, if the cloud cover donut chart reads 0%, this would mean the most photo captured based on your filters, which we'll cover shortly, were captured when skies were clear, or, said another way, when there was 0% cloud cover. Scrolling down the movement summary page further, you'll find filtering options. These filtering options are the same across the movement summary, as well as all the charts we'll be covering next. To use the filtering options within the movement summary, as well as across all the remaining charts we'll be looking at in a second, simply select your desired filters below the charts. The first filter is the time range dropdown, which represents the range of time you want to analyze. As an example, selecting last 2 weeks will pull trail camera data from only the last 2 weeks. Next, the camera filter allows you to select which specific cameras you would like to display. Next, the species filter allows you to select the specific animals you would like the chart to represent. If you select buck as one of these filters, you will see two additional filters pop up for buck name and buck age. If you have been labeling your buck photos with names and/or ages, you will see these selections as filtering options. These options will allow you to view charts representing specific bucks if desired. After selecting all your filters, make sure to tap the Save Changes button to reset the charts to your current filters. If you choose not to save any filters, the charts will simply default to showing all your cameras and photo data. Moving on from the movement summary, the first detailed chart is the time chart. The time chart provides an overview of animal movement throughout a 24-hour day. Several filtering options are provided below the summary chart, including time span, camera name, species, buck age, and buck name. To read the chart, the x-axis represents time on an hourly basis, and the y-axis represents the number of photos captured during a given hour, based on the filtering options saved below the chart. Available research generally states that white-tailed deer will be more active around dawn or dusk as compared to midday. Utilizing the BuckSort time chart, users are better able to hone in on the specific times of day deer in their area are more active, and with available filtering options, including for time span, users can further narrow their findings so that they are recent, season-specific, or buck-specific. The second detailed chart is the temperature chart. The temperature chart provides an overview of animal movement based on temperature. Several filtering options are provided below the summary chart, including time span, camera name, species, buck age, and buck name. To read the chart, the x-axis represents temperature in degrees Fahrenheit, and the y-axis represents the number of photos captured at a given temperature based on the filtering options saved below the chart. Available research generally states that white-tailed deer will be more active in cooler to colder temperatures as compared to warmer temperatures. Utilizing the BuckSort temperature chart, users are better able to hone in on the specific temperatures, leading to increased deer movement in their area. And with available filtering options, including for time span, users can further narrow their findings so that they are recent, season-specific, or buck-specific. The third detailed chart is the barometric pressure chart. The barometric pressure chart provides an overview of animal movement based on barometric pressure. Several filtering options are available below the summary chart, including time span, camera name, species, buck age, and buck name. To read the chart, the x-axis represents pressure in inches of mercury, and the y-axis represents the number of photos captured at a given pressure based on the filtering options saved below the chart. Available research generally states that white-tailed deer will be more active during pressure changes, such as before or after a weather front. At sea level, the average barometric pressure is 29.9 inches of mercury, so be sure to look for increased movement when pressures deviate from this average. Utilizing the BuckSort pressure chart, users are better able to hone in on the specific barometric pressures leading to increased deer movement in their area, and with available filtering options, including for time span, users can further narrow their findings so that they are recent, season-specific, and buck-specific. The fourth detailed chart is the wind speed chart. The wind speed chart provides an overview of animal movement based on wind speed. Several filtering options are available below the summary chart, including time span, camera name, species, buck age, and buck name. To read the chart, the x-axis represents wind speed in miles per hour, and the y-axis represents the number of photos captured at a given wind speed based on the filtering options saved below the chart. Available research generally states that white-tailed deer, particularly mature bucks, will use wind to their advantage, suggesting increased movement when there is a breeze or even more significant wind. Utilizing the BuckSort wind speed chart, users are better able to hone in on the specific wind speeds leading to increased deer movement in their area, and with available filtering options, including for time span, users can further narrow their findings so that they are recent, season-specific, or buck-specific. The fifth detailed chart is the precipitation chart. The precipitation chart provides an overview of animal movement based on precipitation. Several filtering options are available below the summary chart, including time span, camera name, species, buck age, and buck name. To read the chart, the x-axis represents precipitation in inches, and the y-axis represents the number of photos captured at a given precipitation level based on the filtering options saved below the chart. Available research generally states that weather fronts and associated precipitation may influence whitetail movement. Utilizing the BuckSort precipitation chart, users are better able to hone in on the specific amounts of precipitation leading to increased or decreased deer movement in their area. And with available filtering options, including for time span, users can further narrow their findings so that they are recent, season-specific, or buck-specific. The final detailed chart is the cloud cover chart. The cloud cover chart provides an overview of animal movement based on cloud cover. Several filtering options are available below the summary chart, including time span, camera name, species, buck age, and buck name. To read the chart, the x-axis represents cloud cover as a percentage, and the y-axis represents the number of photos captured at a given cloud cover based on the filtering options saved below the chart. Available research generally states that white-tailed deer prefer clearer skies. Utilizing the BuckSort cloud cover chart, users are better able to hone in on the specific cloud cover percentages, leading to increased or decreased deer movement in their area. And with available filtering options, including for time span, users can further narrow their findings so that they are recent, season-specific, or buck-specific. Thank you for checking out the BuckSort app and for watching this tutorial. If you have any questions, feel free to visit our website at www.bucksortpro.com or email us at info@bucksortpro.com. Thank you.